We had a really cool opportunity this year to combine social studies and science curriculum with some support from the writing classes. Our students created ultimate civilizations based on what they learned from ancient civilizations, kind of what to do and what not to do in a civilization.
We've learned about how they started, why they're successful, and eventually how did they fail. And overall, the project was just asking us to create a civilization based on our knowledge to be able to create one that lasts forever.
Once they've created this, what they deemed was perfect civilization, they were then given a real world science problem: rising CO2 levels, outbreak of bacteria, erupting volcanoes, and then they had to use the civilization that they set up with the form of government to address that issue and save their civilization. And they didn't know that their civilization was going to face any science problems.
So we'd like randomly choose a problem without knowing what it is. And so what we had to do is do further research into ways to stop it.
One of our groups actually emailed a scientist that works at Yellowstone and is one of the volcano experts, and had some dialogue back and forth with the scientist through Yellowstone. So that was really cool to see them take the initiative, and the scientist actually emailed him back and gave him feedback on his solution.
The toughest part was, like, in the end, pulling it all together in presenting.
The final presentation kind of has a dual purpose. It is a way, in kind of a one-stop shop, to give both their science and social studies teacher their, you know, culminating presentation, what they've created. But it also gives them a professional experience where they are up in front of a panel of judges who are adults, answering questions that they don't know are coming, making sure they have background knowledge, and giving them, you know, experience to interact with adults.
It was a really good final project. Since it was more creativity and not just an essay, and we got to work with people.
We've seen kids bring in working models that show how they're going to create hydroelectric energy, and they've shown how by running water through a system they've actually created light. Other groups have brought in algae lamps to cut down on CO2, which none of those were requirements. Those were all just students going above and beyond and bringing that extra element to their presentation. This has been the best example of why what we learn is relevant. So the students are doing what policymakers today are doing. They're seeing that what they've learned in seventh grade social studies and seventh grade science actually do go together. They're solving problems that our world leaders are facing today.